Why did it stop moving? Looks like it's out of battery. Aha! Hey, Simon, John, Jen, Caitlin, it's Tookney. Can you send me some batteries? Thanks! Okay, I don't have any spare batteries, and that battery gave my car energy to move. I know you can't destroy or create energy, but it can be transferred from one form to another. So how can I transfer energy to my car? So I did some research, and this is what I learned. All energy is classified as potential energy, also known as stored energy, or kinetic energy, also known as moving energy. Since you can't create or destroy energy, energy is constantly transforming into another type. For example, if I pull on this rubber band, it now has potential or elastic energy. There's energy stored inside the rubber band, but how do I release the energy? Yep, I can let go. There's no more energy stored in the rubber bands, so where did it go? It was transformed into kinetic energy. There was also some sound energy released. Did you hear it? Can you think of any other types of stored energy? Now let's look at some other types of energy and how they can be transformed. This steam iron changes electrical energy to heat, sound, and kinetic energy. This elephant toothpaste reaction changes potential chemical energy to kinetic and heat energy. This elastic-powered launcher changes kinetic energy to potential elastic energy to sound and kinetic energy. Here's a cool energy-transforming machine, a hand-crank flashlight. Can you name all the energy transformations happening here? Are you ready? Here's the answer. John's using kinetic energy to move the crank. That energy changes to mechanical energy as the gears inside the hand crank move around. The gears release some sound energy but also change to electrical energy as it powers the light bulb. Finally, the light bulb releases both heat and light energy. Wouldn't it be so cool if I could make a car move with sound? Sound, energy, go! That didn't work. Maybe I need something with more energy? Can I make my car explode with movement using chemical energy? First, I need to know more about chemical and physical reactions. I'm gonna pass it over to Caitlin, who's gonna help explain.
Matter can change in two ways, physically or chemically. In a physical change, the appearance or form is altered, but no new substances are created. For example, if a peach is cut up into many pieces, it will look different, but it's still made of peach. Or when an ice cube melts and changes state from solid to liquid, it's still made of water, H2O. Have you ever wondered why popcorn pops? It's because of a physical change inside the popcorn kernel. Liquid water inside the kernel undergoes a change of state. What do you think the water becomes? A gas or a solid? Here's a hint. You're giving it energy by heating in the microwave or on the stovetop. Chemical changes do create new substances. The particles of matter that have been mixed together combine in a different way to make something new. For example, when you bake cookies, the ingredients you mix together to make the dough are transformed into a cookie. These types of changes are usually irreversible. You can't get the flour or butter back out of the cookie, but you can enjoy the new substance. Some clues or indicators of a chemical change are production of a gas, like the smell when something bakes, a change in color, like how the dough turns brown while it bakes, or formation of a precipitate, a new solid made from chemically reacting liquids. Physical and chemical changes can both be used to make something move. In power plants, electricity is generated by boiling water to produce steam, which moves to turn a propeller in the turbine. In rockets, either solid or liquid chemicals are mixed together and react to form a gas. Since gases take up more room, a larger volume than liquids or solids, this pushes the rocket upwards.
Here's my chemical reaction car. I taped a plastic bottle to the end and put a pushpin in the cap. I'm gonna fill it up with baking soda and vinegar, shake it up, and then take out the pushpin to let out the gas from the chemical reaction. Let's see if it works. No, it didn't work. Test 2. I use a lot more baking soda and vinegar, and I'm gonna wait longer for the gas to build up before I take out the push pin. Yeah! I wonder what my friends are doing. Sent me a gift. Great, it's a battery for my car. Now that I have some energy, I'm gonna pass it on to you. It's your turn. Can you build a really cool energy transforming machine? And remember, if it doesn't work the first time, you can do some research, try out different strategies to figure it out. Remember to ask, test, repeat.